What limits you? Too small? Too old? Insecure? Broken? You have no limits. Rethink your limits.
This is the OPS pregame report.
We are live from Homestead High School as we get set for this afternoon's boys basketball matchup between the Homestead Spartans and North Central Panthers. Hello once again, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Matt Saalfrank alongside Chris Kohrman and our sideline reporter, Jenner Lane, as we are about 15 minutes away from tip-off of today's matchup, thanks to Braden Carroll and Noah Johanningsmeyer, who were on the call for the girls' game that just concluded. As we saw, the Lady Spartans fall to North Central 66-47. And Chris, no other place to start this pregame show than what Homestead junior Fletcher Lawyer did on Tuesday against Marion. He scored a school record 50 points, breaking the old record that was held by Tim Dunn with 44 points back in the 2009-2010 season. Lawyer shot 20 of 29 from the field to get his 50 points, while also putting up 4 rebounds, 5 assists, 5 steals, and an impressive 0 turnovers in a 92-77 win over Marion this past Tuesday night.
Well, where else would you want to start besides Fletcher Lawyer with the 50 points? You know, really good game for Homestead. Homestead came out, you know, a little flat in that game and couldn't get anything going. And Lawyer had 19 points there in that first half, and then all of a sudden, you know, it started to ramp up, and he ended the game with 50 points, you know, breaking a school record. You know, it's not something that we see, you know, every game someone, you know, coming out with 50 points, and Fletcher Lawyer, definitely a special part of this Homestead team.
Yeah, and this Homestead team, it's been a while since they've last been at home. They've played 6 games away from home, Chris. As you look at their schedule now, you know, they were at New Haven, at Lewers, and they played St. Joe at Grace College, and then Warren Central and Brownsburg on the same day at Carroll High School. Then this past Tuesday, they were at Marion. So it's been a while since this Homestead team has actually played here at Homestead.
Now, that's a tough stretch right there. You know, you play 6 straight games on the road, and then you come out with 6 straight victories. Now, that's definitely a stretch that proves that this Homestead team are definitely a force to be reckoned with. That big game right there, South Bend St. Joe, came out all over them. You know, that was definitely a huge win for this Homestead team. You know, playing 6 straight games on the road, tough task to even win 4, but Homestead won all 6.
We're just getting started here in the pregame report. Still ahead, we'll take a look at the visiting Panthers, break down the standings from both conferences, and preview what to expect in today's game. We'll be right back.
This is the OPS pregame report.
Welcome back to the OPS pregame show as we get closer to tip-off of today's matchup between the Homestead Spartans and North Central Panthers. And now let's take a look at Homestead's opponent today, the North Central Panthers. They're 4-4 on the season, but those 4 losses are coming by an average of 6 points into some of the top competition in the state, Chris.
Yeah, definitely. You know, when you're playing a tough schedule like North Central does, I think that just proves that, you know, this team their record might not be the best, but playing those tough opponents, they definitely go on, you know, some runs down the stretch, maybe a postseason run playing tough teams. You know, I think that's definitely something that Coach Johnson, you know, wants to do is play some tough teams. You know, like, you know, like we just saw playing six straight games on the road. You know, two of them coming against teams down south. So playing tough teams, you know, definitely helps you better yourself down the stretch.
And let's see how both of these teams are faring in their conference at this point in the season. Homestead, they're one of three unbeaten teams in the SAC, tied at the top of the standings along with Carroll and Snyder.
Yeah, Homestead coming out firing 2-0 in conference and 10-0 overall, but Carroll and Snyder, they're not going away, and very excited for those two matchups down the stretch. And then Dwenger's out for 2 weeks. They had some COVID go down with Bishop Dwenger, so they're out for 2 weeks. So, you know, we're going to see Dwenger, you know, their overall is not going to fall. But, you know, Homestead, Carroll, Snyder, they're definitely the three top teams in the SAC, and Homestead's going to have some tough matchups down the stretch.
And while North Central's 0-1 in the MIC, that loss came by 7 points to the number two ranked team in Class 4A, the Carmel Greyhounds. Now looking at the MIC standings, no surprise to see Carmel and Lawrence North at the top.
You know, Carmel just barely getting Lawrence North by, you know, one win, but Lawrence North got a really tough game today, and, you know, very excited to see that game happen. I think it starts at 6:30 tonight. Lawrence North playing Attic, so that's a huge game. And we're going to see what Lawrence North can do in that game, but it was a very tough conference. So, you know, you got Carmel in there, and then, you know, Warren Central, a team that Homestead barely beat. So that's definitely a very good conference.
Yeah, this Homestead team, they're 10-0 overall on the season, currently ranked number three in Class 4A. As you saw, Carmel and Lawrence North, they're the top two teams in 4A. Homestead, they're ranked number three in 4A. So North Central certainly used to this type of competition against a Homestead team of this quality, one of the best they've had in the past few years. As this Homestead team, they have their hands full against North Central today, Chris.
No doubt about that. You know, we were on call for the girls game, and when North Central walked in, the first thing we saw was they're tall. And, you know, that means they're going to play athletic, and they're going to play with speed. So, you know, don't be surprised if they come out and try and push the floor and, you know, just get in transition and get some easy buckets that way.
And this Homestead team, they're led by top two players, Fletcher Lawyer and Luke Goody. Fletcher Lawyer leads the team with 24.9 points per game, while Luke Goody is second on the team with 18.8 points per game. But don't forget about players like Grant Simmons averaging 11.3 a game and Andrew Leeper 8.8 points per game, or even someone like Caleb Colpian or either the Kopwikis or Quinn Harmon. All those are really solid players in this Homestead team.
Well, it's definitely the players that Coach Johnson looks for. I know he always subs his first three players in, and so he's Kopwikis, Brothers, and Harmon. So, you know, Coach Johnson feels really comfortable putting those three in. This Homestead team, it's not always just one player that can fire on all cylinders. And then Caleb Colpine, you know, his defense, I think that's what gets, you know, unsaid. But his defense has been really good this year. He's been playing, you know, the best players on each team. So he's been stepping up in that aspect.
And you look at North Central now. They are 4-4 overall on the season, led by head coach Jason Gardner in his first year at North Central. We're going to talk about him quite a bit more as the broadcast goes on. North Central 4-4 on the season. They're ranked 11th, though, in the Sagarin ratings, the computer rankings. So they're really a good team, but just play a very tough schedule. They actually have the fourth toughest schedule out of the, 400-some teams in the state of Indiana right now. So they're certainly prepared for a team like Homestead, how good they are. They're used to playing that competition. I mean, they just lost on Wednesday to 3A number 2 Hammond by 3 points. They're a solid team in this Homestead team. And they can't overlook North Central, even though their record doesn't show that they are a top team. They really are one of the best teams in the MIC.
Yeah, they're, you know, like I said, they're going to look to push the basketball down the court and try and get transition. You know, this is a team the Homestead played last year. And, you know, they had a tough time with them. A lot has changed since then, of course. You know, this Homestead team's gotten better, and North Central lost some players, but it's definitely not a team you can overlook.
And last season, North Central, they went 12-10 overall, with one of those 12 wins coming against Homestead. They lost to Warren Central in the first round of sectional. They do return a lot of talent, someone like Leland Walker, Chris, one of the best players in the Indianapolis area.
Oh, no doubt about that right there. We got Leland Walker in there, and that's definitely the force of this North Central team. You know, he can shoot the ball really well, you know, averaging 20 points per game, you know. So he definitely sets the tone for this North Central team. And, you know, he's verbally committed to IUPUI. So, you know, he's definitely getting the looks from the colleges.
Yeah, Walker has quite a few offers. As now we look back at this Homestead team, they're led by head coach Chris Johnson. He's been around quite a while, 22 years at Homestead, 27 years overall. He's won 7 sectionals, 2 regionals, 1 semi-state, and 1 state back in 2015 here at Homestead. His postseason record is very good, 38-19. That's a 67% winning percentage. Homestead, they're currently in Class 4A, which is the largest class in Indiana. Enrollment is 2,424 students, which was based off of last school year, and they're the 20th largest high school in Indiana based on enrollment out of 403 IHSAA-eligible schools. North Central, I think they're in the top 5 of largest schools in the state, so you have 2 of the biggest schools in the state matching up against each other today.
Like you said about Coach Johnson, he's got a good, very good reputation when it comes to Indiana basketball. He's had found a lot of success, and you know he's definitely one of the coaches that gets a lot of respect in the area, and he definitely deserves it. This Homestead team, they're playing a tough opponent today.
Homestead and North Central matching up today in this doubleheader. Chris, we saw the girls play earlier. They couldn't quite hold on, couldn't quite get that traveling trophy from North Central. They really struggled from the three-point line, but exciting to have some fans here. You know, around us there's some crowd noise rather than just us whispering when someone's shooting a free throw when it gets so quiet, as we have done in the past for the girls' games. But Homestead and North Central tip-off coming in about, I don't know, 4 minutes or so from right now, and we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we're going to have starting lineups and get set for tip right after this.
What limits you? Too small, too old, insecure, broken. You have no limits. Rethink your limits.
Here at Homestead High School Media, we're taking steps to stay safe during the COVID-19 pandemic. That includes limiting the number of workers in the TV studio and wearing masks when not on camera. We also socially distance our anchors each week at the news desk. In the studios, we limit the number of people allowed in at a time, and even our mics wear masks. Thank you for doing your part in helping fight COVID-19.
Today, it's the first non-conference doubleheader matchup.
Puts up a shot. It's good. The Lawyer, another three-pointer. Got it again.
The girls looking to take down a number 2 ranked team. The boys looking to maintain their undefeated streak and move to 11-0 on the season. North Central at Homestead. Exclusive coverage by Homestead Live.
Big matchup between Homestead, ranked 3rd in Class 4A, 10-0 on the season, and a North Central team that has one of the toughest schedules in the state coming in at 4-4 on the season.
And definitely, like you said, you know, they're playing a tough conference and playing the Carmels and all those teams. So, you know, this team, they definitely can't be overlooked by just their record. You know, they're a very good team. It's a tough matchup for Homestead while playing a team that's going to look to go fast and move the ball really well.
Homestead, North Central tip-off coming up in just a few minutes. But first up, Fletcher Lawyer is going to be honored for his 1,000th point scored. Fletcher Lawyer, kind of a very cool thing to see. Scored 1,000 points already in his career, just a junior. That was in a win against Brownsburg a while back. Lawyer put up 50 points in a win over Marion on Tuesday, averaging 24.9 points per game right now, one of the top scorers in the area. Currently a junior, Chris, and so cool to see Lawyer reach 1,000 points when he's here at Homestead in his first season after transferring from Michigan over the offseason.
Definitely a special aspect to this, you know, Homestead team is Fletcher Lawyer. He's able to create opportunities on offense and get it going.
Now getting into the starting lineups. Yeah, Walker, Williams, Elliott. Brown also getting the start, only a sophomore. And Shiloh Jackson, a 6'8" center. So this North Central team, they have some height, Chris.
Yeah, they definitely do. You know, that's one thing we saw when they walked in. We saw the height, and I'm sure they're going to be looking to use it early on.
The starting lineup now for the Homestead Spartans. It'll be Fletcher Lawyer, committed to play basketball at Purdue, a current junior, averaging 24.9 points per game, 5 rebounds and 5 assists, while shooting 49% from 3. It'll also be Caleb Colpin, committed to play baseball at Taylor University, a current senior, as well as Andrew Leeper, a current junior with multiple offers. And you also have Grant Simmons, committed to play baseball at Huntington University. Then rounding out the starting five is Luke Goody, signed to play basketball at Illinois, a senior for Homestead.
That's Homestead team. You know, they look to just keep the same lineup, same as the girls do. They just keep the same lineup, feel really comfortable with it. You know, like I said, don't look for those three players, Kapuiki, Brothers, and Harmon, to be subbed in, you know, early on.
Really excited for this matchup. Two high-quality teams. I mean, Homestead, they've had their taste of Indy area teams. They've had Brownsburg and Warren Central already. They beat Warren Central by 3, and then they beat Brownsburg pretty easily. Both those games were played on the same day, as it'll be Leeper and Jackson to jump. This opening tip, what are some, I guess we'll get into the keys a little while, but 0-0, 8 minutes on the clock, this boys basketball matchup. Controlled by Lawyer, Homestead to start with the ball. Mentioned Lawyer committed to play at Purdue. He's someone that transferred from Clarkston High School in Michigan over the summer. Set the school record with 50 points on Tuesday against Marion, as Homestead their first possession of the game. Now to Simmons. High pass recovered by Lawyer. And Fletcher Lawyer actually ranked the number one free throw shooter in the country by Max Preps, you know, based on a minimum. We're not talking one of one here. He's 38 of 39 at the free throw line, as that shot is good. Underneath by Grant Simmons, his first basket of the game. Senior that averages 11.3 points per game on the season. 6'4" forward. Now North Central, they're led by Leland Walker. Number 2, can't get that shot. Out of bounds. Going to Homestead.
A good start right there on offense by Homestead. Good put in by Grant Simmons.
2-0 Homestead early on. Underneath, wide open Simmons again, the second basket of the game. Grant Simmons had 13 points against Marion on Tuesday. Missed 2 games this season with an injury. Well, he's had 5 games of 10-plus points. 3-pointer there. It is good by Elliott for North Central. 4-3 Homestead on top. Simmons again. Wow, he's on fire, Chris.
You know, I think this North Central team might be a little too focused on Lawyer and Goody. They're just going to leave Simmons wide open, and Simmons going to hit those shots.
All of Homestead's 7 points so far. Three-pointer, that's good. Williams knocks down the three ball for the Panthers. A couple early threes for North Central, but Homestead's still on top by 1 point. Homestead on a 10-game winning streak, 10 wins this season, 10-0, and that's a travel going against Leaper.
That's North Central team. You know, they look like any wide open three you give them, they're going to hit it. So if you're Homestead, you want to stay out on the perimeter and not let them get open.
North Central 4-4 on the season, led by head coach Jason Gardner. Another three ball by North Central. That one missed. Goody the rebound for Homestead. Bad pass. Taken away by the Panthers. Nice move there. Joey Brown able to score. Only a sophomore, 6'6". He's got room to grow for this Panther team as now North Central in front. Lawyer missed that shot for the Spartans. Back and forth so far, Chris, as this North Central team looking solid as another three-pointer. That one's good by Williams, his second three-pointer of the game. Now with 6 points, B.J. Williams. The Panthers up by four.
On North Central, you know, they can't miss right now anytime. Like I said, you can't leave these guys open. They're looking to hit every shot they take from three.
Goody. Rebound to North Central on a one-game losing streak. Shot is no good there. Goody is fouled underneath by the Panthers. First foul of the game for either team. Brown picks up his first, the team's first.
Joey Brown was playing varsity as a freshman last year, so not surprised to see him out in the starting lineup as a sophomore.
Leaper off the iron. This North Central team wants to push it. Williams again missed the shot. Caught off of Homestead, though, staying with North Central.
You know, if North Central, they come down with the rebound, you know they're going to push it. They feel comfortable pushing the ball up the court, so probably not the last time we'll see that.
Their next game is Friday against Ben Davis. North Central, so they have a bit of rest after this game. Homestead down by four. Grant Simmons with all of Homestead's points so far. Lawyer packs the basket. He is fouled on the way up. So Fletcher Lawyer, one of the best free throw shooters in the country. 38 of 39, 97%. Not a point so far, but he has a chance at a few right here. That foul is going against Jackson for North Central. Got that one.
All right, gentlemen, here we go. One shot.
Leaper did a good job down there on defense, you know, fighting off those couple big guys that North Central has.
Well, you're now 40 of 41 on free throws this season. We have a sub. That's Boyd, 6'5" senior, in for North Central. Walker has offers from Providence, FIU, Little Rock, Middle Tennessee, Ball State, Winthrop, Xavier, and IUPUI, according to verbal commits. Averaged over 20 points per game last season as a sophomore. Travel called against Elliott.
It's a good stand there by the Homestead defense, forcing a North Central turnover. Now if you're Homestead, you look to tie this game up or even take a one-point lead with a three.
Colpin to Leaper underneath, wide open. Lawyer scores the easy two. Now with 4 points, Fletcher Lawyer, it's tied at 11. This first quarter, 3:07 to go. Walker, crossover on Colpin, step back. That's missed. Goody. Spin around, jump shot, and traffic. Luke Goody, his first basket of the game, averages 18.8 points per game on the season, shooting 42% from the field and 46% from two. Brown crosses over Goody. Lost it though. Nice defense by Luke Goody as he goes out of bounds and a turnover on North Central.
That's really good defense right there by Luke Goody, able to force him to go back on the perimeter and then force him to take it out of bounds. That's good defense right there by Luke Goody. I look for Homestead to capitalize off that.
Clark in for Williams for the Panthers. Close game so far. 2:18 to go in the first. Lawyer drives. Ooh, missed that one. You don't see him miss a whole lot of those two-pointers, shooting 59% from two on the season coming into this game.
I had to move down low and was able to get by his defender, so, you know, Lawyer's going to feel confident to keep doing that. So don't be surprised if he goes down and tries that same thing again.
Yeah, Lawyer has not shot worse than 50% from the field since December 5th. That's more than 11 field goal attempts in each of those games.
It's a good block there by Leaper, forcing a little tough shot right there with the block.
Pretty clean game so far. Homestead no fouls and North Central two fouls. As Goody steps into a three-pointer, shoots 37% from the arc this season, now with 5 points in the game. Simmons scored the first 7 points for Homestead. This three ball by the Panthers. Simmons finally comes away with it. Leaper. Attacks the basket. 2 points. And a timeout called by North Central. And Chris taking a look. Actually, Spartan fans, don't forget that both Spartan basketball teams will be in action again next Friday in another SAC doubleheader. They take on the Southside Archers here at home. Tip-off is set for 6 p.m. for the girls and the boys tip-off after. Join broadcasters Braden Carroll and Noah Johanningsmeyer on the call for the girls game, and Chris and myself will be on after for the boys game. Again, that's next Friday on Homestead Live. And that girls game, that's going to be a big one. I mean, Southside unbeaten in the SAC and Homestead, and they really can't afford another loss. Already one loss in the SAC this season.
That's what I was thinking, you know, just right as you said it. You know, that girls game, that's a huge matchup for Homestead. They already got their one loss. The SAC, Southside has none. So, you know, Homestead going to look to maybe turn the tides there in the SAC with a victory over Southside.
Out of the timeout, it's 18-11, Homestead over North Central. 1:12 to go in the first.
Good run right there by Homestead, you know, forcing North Central to take a timeout and think about it. But Homestead on a good run. It was a big three right there by Luke Goody.
North Central went 12-10 last season overall. They lost to Warren Central in the first round of their sectional. They average about 66 points per game, give up 60.6, so only lose by an average of 5.4 points per game. So that 4-4 record, I mean, a lot of them, all those losses have been close. That's a nice block by Goody on Boyd.
North Central's looking to go down low, but Homestead, they seem to have a really good answer for that. They're moving guys down low. And they're able to force a block right there by Luke Goody. So that was a really good stand by the Homestead defense.
Homestead on an 11-0 run. Lawyer across half court. Over to Goody. Those are two of the best players really in the area. They have Lawyer going to Purdue, and then Luke Goody from Homestead going to Illinois to play basketball. And you don't really find a lot of teams with this kind of college commitments nowadays. Two future Big Ten players, Chris.
Right, no doubt about that. You know, there's not really schools around here that have two Big Ten commits.
Nice shot by Luke Goody as he is up to 7 points now. Shot is missed. End of the first quarter. Homestead leading 20-11 over North Central. We'll be right back after this.
What limits you? Too small, too old, insecure, broken. You have no limits. Rethink your limits.
start of the second quarter. It's 20-11 Homestead over North Central. Thanks for joining us. As the Spartans got out to a quick start with Grant Simmons scoring the team's first 7 points. Lil Goody also added 7 in that quarter, Lawyer 4, and Leaper with 2. And for North Central, they were led by B.J. Williams with 6 points, Elliott had 3, and Brown with 2 in that first quarter. Homestead able to come away with it.
Good block there by Fletcher Lawyer.
And the senior class at Homestead, they've been pretty solid. They're 65-20. So basically all 4 years of Luke Goody. Takes another shot, missed it there. But back in 2017-18, Homestead, they went 18-8. They won the sectional that year. The next year they went 21-3. They won the SAC regular season and SAC tourney. And last year was kind of a tough year for them. 16-9, they didn't really win anything. No SAC tournament or postseason. And then this year they're off to a great start, 10-0. Goody, another three-pointer. Simmons, the putback, now with 9 points, Grant Simmons. But Chris Johnson, the head coach for Homestead, he's done a solid job over these past 4 years building up the senior class to making them how good they are right now. I mean, I know it helps Fletcher Lawyer coming in, but a lot of these guys have really been playing, you know, on the freshman team when they were freshmen or the JV team the past few years, and right now they're playing at a really high level. Simmons scores again for Homestead. And timeout called by North Central, 24-11, Homestead leading. We'll be right back.
Here at Homestead High School Media, we're taking steps to stay safe during the COVID-19 pandemic. That includes limiting the number of workers in the TV studio and wearing masks when not on camera. We also socially distance our anchors each week at the news desk. In the studios, we limit the number of people allowed in at a time, and even our mics wear masks. Thank you for doing your part in helping fight COVID-19.
Out of the timeout, it's 24-11 Homestead, and I believe the Spartans are on a 17-0 run right now going back to the first quarter. Feels like they've got quite a few baskets that have just been in transition and wide open as North Central turning it over a lot recently.
Well, yeah, Homestead's coming up with some big defensive stands, couple blocks in there as well for this Homestead team. So their defense definitely stepping up, and the offense, you know, they're playing, you know, hand-in-hand with each other, and Grant Simmons, you know, coming up with a big game, you know, already. So, you know, I think when you see a guy score 50 points, you know, you're going to hone in on him, but you can't forget about Grant Simmons.
Quinn Harmon and Caden Kopwicki in the game. As Homestead, they're shooting 10 of 17 from the field, and North Central just 4 of 18 in this game. Walker. Underneath, that's Boyd. And Boyd, I mean, I could see him being a college football player. I mean, he's huge. D lineman, maybe.
Yeah, definitely could see a football player.
I mean, 6'5" and, I don't know, probably, what, 230? He's got, certainly has a size, but missed the free throw right there. Boyd, a senior for North Central. They're led by Jason Gardner, who's in his first year at North Central. He was actually the 1999 Mr. Basketball, and he returns to North Central after coaching at IUPUI from 2014 to 2019. Is that second free throw to end the Homestead 17-0 run is good by Boyd. A couple subs in now. Caden Kopwicki and Quinn Harmon. I mean, they don't average a ton of points. Kopwicki, 2.6 points per game. Harmon, 1.5. But they play a lot of big minutes off the bench for this Homestead team.
Especially when last game, when Luke Goody went down some foul trouble, they both saw heavy minutes down the stretch, and they definitely stepped up like that next man mentality for this Homestead basketball team, especially when a guy goes down with foul trouble.
Yeah, series history, North Central 1-0. I mean, they played last year, so not a whole lot of history between these teams. Homestead coming up a huge win over Marion, and then you see that last year, North Central, they won. A lot of stats right there. North Central averages 66 points per game, 2-1 on the road this season. Lawyer underneath, made the shot. And Fletcher Lawyer, another basket for him.
Good push right there by Homestead, pushing the ball up the court and not slowing down. And that's a good drive right there by Lawyer.
Lawyer, 6 points today. Make that seven. After he completes the and one, averages 24.9 points per game this season. He's had 720 plus point games and 330 plus point games.
Oh!
Nice defense there by Olmsted, but they were called for the foul as Brown attacked the basket.
I think Fletcher Lawyer being number one, you know, in free throws. I mean, when you go down the stretch in postseason games, free throws are big. And if Fletcher Lawyer gets the line, you know, Homestead's going to be feeling really confident about him hitting the free throws.
Good. He picks up that foul as we have Joey Brown, sophomore. Missed that free throw. This Homestead team has really taken over thanks to a 17-0 run that went back to the first quarter, also the first part of the second quarter. Both misses by Brown. As Homestead, they trailed 11-7 at one point in this game. Now up by 15 points, and the Spartans really showing why they are ranked number three in the state. As Lawyer pulls up. Got it! Fletcher Lawyer, a three-pointer, up to double digits. 10 points on the game for Lawyer. 30-12 lead for Homestead. 23-1 run over North Central right now. Goody makes the extra pass. Over to Kyron Copley. He's in the game now. Tipped out of bounds, staying with Homestead.
The Homestead on a very good run. Like you said, you know, they're moving the ball well. They're passing the ball around. This Homestead team doing an all-around good job this game in all, you know, all three stages.
Harmon gets into the Lawyer. Another three-pointer. That's about as close as you can get to making it without it actually going in. That spun around, what, two or three times. Walker gets the shot in traffic. Homestead looking for their 11th win of the season. Have not lost yet. The only unbeaten overall team in the SAC, as we'll talk about soon at halftime. Goody, nice move. Short off the front of the rim. No good by Kyron Kapuiki. Is want to be careful to avoid any scuffles. There's that replay. That was so close by Lawyer. But Simmons actually picks up the foul. That's his first of the game.
Well, that's surprising. I'd have thought the foul went on Kyron Kapuiki, but they give it to Simmons there.
Walker double teamed by Goody and Kyron Kapuiki. Lob underneath, poked away by Lawyer's Jackson, a 6'8" senior center, went up with it.
That's way right there by Fletcher Lawyer, jumping to the basketball. You know, they trapped Walker up top, and they were able to, you know, get the speed down low and stop him from scoring.
Good move by B.J. Williams. His first basket in a while, but has 8 points on the game, leading North Central in the scoring category. He has half of the team's points. It's Olmsted still up by 14. Goody somehow scores. Now with 9 points. Already more than he had against Marion, as makes a good defensive play. We're going to give it to Homestead. As in that Marion game, you see Goody's shot again there. Goody dealt with a lot of foul trouble. Didn't really play a whole lot of that game. He had 4 fouls pretty early on in the second half. So his points a little bit lower than you would normally expect, but didn't really matter as Fletcher Lawyer put up 50 points on Tuesday. What was a comeback win? I mean, Homestead, we were there. They were down in the first half quite a bit, and they were able to come back.
I think with this team, you know, when they get down, you know, you're not necessarily worried about it. I mean, I wouldn't say I was, you know, that worried about it, but, you know, this team, Marion definitely came out firing on all cylinders, and Homestead had to battle back, and You know, every team's going to face adversity, so not every game's going to be a 20-point victory.
An open Simmons knocks down the three-pointer as Grant Simmons has 14 points, one away from his season high, which was back against Warsaw when he put up 15. That was one of the first games of the season. Grant Simmons, he's been struggling from three this year, only 29%, but was able to knock one down in the last possession. Outlet pass to Lawyer. Takes it in. Walker comes away with it for North Central. Walker, what a great player. Somehow able to, through all that traffic, just go to the basket and score.
You know, all sorts of contact right there. He's able to get through and get the and-one.
Elliott in the lineup for North Central. Walker with a free throw. To complete the and-one. Got it. Now with 5 points, Leland Walker. Averaged over 20 points per game last season as a sophomore. Played big in North Central's win over Homestead last season. Oh, Simmons! Oh, I think he might have. Oh, he didn't push off. I don't know. What do you think about that, Chris? That was quite the crossover.
Yep.
But they get him for the offensive foul.
It's a tough call to make right there by the official, but, you know, he gives the way to North Central. You know, it looked like a really good crossover, but I guess there was too much of a push-off. Maybe.
2 minutes to go in this second quarter. As Homestead just dominating. Yeah, at one point had a 17-0 run. Goody pulls up and drills it again. Luke Goody's on fire this game. Now with 12 points. Averages 18.8 points per game. North Central struggling, but finally, an Elliott put back. Puts them on the board again. Goody. Nice effort by Luke Goody. Simmons missed a three-pointer, and Luke Goody able to go back up with it. Already having a great game.
Yeah, Luke Goody leads the team with four double-doubles this year. You know, that's an outstanding stat for him. So, you know, he's coming out firing in this game, doing a good job already.
Goody with 14 points. He also leads the team in rebounds with 8.6 a game and assists with 5.3 a game. Missed that free throw, though. Goody was 80% at the line coming into this game. 19-point lead for Homestead. Approaching the final minute of this half. Three-pointer on the way, and that is good.
3 points, my ability.
Elliott, a three ball, up to 8 points.
Well, you know this North Central team, they're not going to go away. I mean, they're not just going to get down like that. They're going to try and find the open three, and right there they hit another one.
Homestead's had a pretty solid first half, already 40 points scored. As Leeper just lost it. Leeper only averages 1.3 turnovers per game in the starting lineup. Something weird for Leeper, he's shooting 66% from the field, 77% from two, and 11% from three. There's a stretch, two-game stretch where he went 12 of 12 from two against Lures and St. Joe a while back. He's not hit a three-pointer since December 12th. At New Haven. 10 seconds to go. Homestead basketball. 5 seconds. Goody, a deep three. It's good! Luke Goody to end this first half. Walker nearly makes it at the end of the first half. It's 43-24. Homestead with the lead over North Central. A good first half for the Spartans. Now let's send it down to sideline reporter Jenna Lane, who's with Homestead head coach Chris Johnson.
Hi, thanks. So coach, right now you're leading by 19 points at the half. So what do you assess your team's performance?
Well, we're shooting the ball extremely well in the first half. I think we're moving the ball well. It's going to come down to defensively being able to stop their dribble penetration. But, you know, I think for the most part, we're doing a good job.
Thank you so much. Matt, back to you.
Thanks, Jenna. And, yeah, this Homestead team, they're really playing good right now, up 43-24. Luke Goody with 17 points at the half. Simmons has 14. And we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we're going to have the OPS halftime show right after this.
What limits you? Too small, too old, insecure, broken. You have no limits. Rethink your limits.
This is the OPS Halftime Report.
Back at halftime, it's 43-24, Homestead leading over North Central here at the break. And Homestead, they've been playing pretty solid after a slow few minutes start to that first quarter. 43-24 is the score. Now look at some of these first half stats. Homestead shooting 57% from the field. North Central only 29%. The Spartans 60% on 6 of 10 three-pointers. The rebounding is huge, 20-9 in Homestead's favor, and not too many turnovers in this game.
Well, you know, Homestead only with 4 turnovers, but the 20 rebounds, that definitely stands out. Homestead doing a good job jumping to the basketball. Anytime a shot goes up, they're always the first ones there. That's definitely a key. And, shooting 57%, North Central struggling 29%. So, you know, like Coach Johnson said in that interview, that, defense got to step up. You know, they're hitting their shots, and they just got to play defense and stop North Central from going on a run.
Yeah, Homestead playing pretty good in this first half here at Homestead High School. It's nice to be back here doing the boys basketball game. Chris, I think December 11th was the last time Homestead played here. And look at some of our first half stat leaders, as Luke Goody had a very good first half, 17 points on 70% shooting, and Simmons 14 points on 86% shooting. That's just, you can't really beat teams like that when they're playing that well.
I tell you can't beat a team that can shoot with three, four different guys that are shooting really well. You know, Luke Goody, 17 points, 70%, and then Simmons 14 points for 86%. And when you see a guy that scores 50 points, you're gonna be like, we gotta hone in on him, and then you leave Simmons open, and Simmons definitely not missing his wide open shots tonight.
Yeah, Homestead just dominating so far in this game, and Homestead leading 43-24. Anything stand out to you in that first half, Chris?
20 rebounds, that's definitely a big stat, but I think the way this Homestead team came out, they came out flying, hitting their big shots, and the defense, I think that's definitely one thing that has gone unsaid this whole year is the defense. Like Homestead doing a good job on defense. They're not letting North Central get back in this game. They're just maintaining the lead so far.
And we still have plenty to talk about in the OPS Halftime Report coming up. We take a look at news in the SAC. Stick around. More basketball action coming up on Homestead Live.
rethink your limits.
This is the OPS Halftime Report.
And welcome back to the OPS Halftime Report. And Chris, now let's get into SAC in the news. Some very big storylines we have coming up here in this halftime show as Homestead a big lead. First up, Carson Jenkins scores big as junior. Jenkins puts up 30 points to lead Snyder to a 66-65 win over Elkhart on Wednesday. And Chris, you know, I really can't figure out this Snyder team. I know Carson Jenkins, he can definitely score the basketball, but we'll have to see if they're able to stay consistent when Homestead plays them in not too long from now.
I really don't know much about them either. You know, they're. I just want to see Homestead, you know, go up against Snyder. You know, Snyder's got talent. So I feel like, you know, when Homestead plays Snyder, Snyder's going to show a lot about, you know, who they are as a team.
And then Homestead unbeaten in 4A. They're one of nine teams remaining in Class 4A with an unbeaten record. Pretty impressive, and I'm pretty sure the only 10-0 team or better, at least coming into today. So pretty impressive what Homestead is doing so far this season.
Well, I look for that to continue. You know, this Homestead team off to a, you know, a hot start, you know, 10-0. You can't ask for, you know, much more than that from this Homestead team. They're doing a great job. And, you know, like, look for that to continue, this Homestead team. They're definitely playing really good basketball right now. You know, after that tough six-game stretch, they're still hanging strong at 10-0.
And the final storyline of this half, or headline, is conference play next Friday. It's been a few weeks off since we had the, you know, SAC conference games, and all 10 SAC schools, at least right now, set to resume conference play on Friday. Some of the big games on that day, you have Dwanger at Carroll, Lewers at Concordia, Snyder at Northrop, Wayne at Northside, and Southside at Homestead. Any of those games stand out to you, Chris?
I'm telling you what, on the girls' side, let's talk about Homestead Southside. That's definitely the big game of the night. But, you know, on the boys' side, you know, wouldn't be surprised. Dwanger, they got a really good shooting team. You know, they could give Carroll a run. Carroll undefeated in conference. But, you know, Snyder at Northrop, that could also be an interesting game.
Yeah, so a lot of good games coming up on Friday. But we have a good one here. Can North Central make a final run to close, I guess, this game? I mean, they're down 19 points right now, 43-24. Homestead's offense right where it should be. I mean, anything North Central can do, you think, in this final two quarters to make a late push?
Well, I think defense, you need to step up. I mean, you're giving up 43 points in the first half. You know, if you want to even have a shot to get close to this game, defense has to step up, and then you got to be able to go down the court and hit the shots.
Goody led Homestead with 17 points in that first half. Simmons with 14 points. As we get closer to the start of the third quarter, Homestead up 43-24 right now. We're going to take one last break before we get set with this third quarter of action coming up in just about a minute.
What limits you? What limits you? Too small, too old, insecure, broken. You have no limits. Rethink your limits.
Welcome back to Homestead High School. Start of the third quarter about to begin in just a few moments from now. Homestead was led by Luke Goody, 17 points in that first half. Grant Simmons had 14, Lawyer had 10, and Leaper had 2 points. No one else for Homestead scored.
Yeah, you know, you look for these two. You look for the three. You know, you look for Lawyer. You know, he definitely can hit three ball. Leaper down low, got 2 points. But Simmons and Goody just running the show right now.
Yeah, if Goody keeps it up in the second half, he could have one of the best games of his career. Already 17 points right now. Homestead ball to start this.
34 points against Cathedrals, his high this year.
Start of the third quarter out there for Homestead. Lawyer, Goody, Simmons, Colpeen, and Leaper for North Central. You know, you have Walker, one of their top players. You also have Jackson out there. Williams, as Lawyer goes to the basket, his first point of this second half, 12 for the game. Steal all the way for Homestead. Goody! This is the shot. A couple missed shots underneath for Homestead as North Central comes away with it. You also have Brown out there. Jackson and Elliott on the court for North Central. Down 45 to 24. Let's talk about North Central. For those who don't know a lot about them, as they are from the Indianapolis area. They're led by Jason Gardner, who's in his first year at North Central. He won 1999 Mr. Basketball at North Central. He coached at IUPUI from 2014 to 2019. He played at Arizona from 1999 to 2003, as Homestead collects the rebound there. And Gardner lost to Duke in the 2001 National Championship as a senior in 2003. He was named second team All-America, and his jersey number was retired by Arizona in 2005. He was a two-time All-Star playing professionally in Germany, so it's fair to say North Central head coach Jason Gartner for sure knows his basketball.
Oh, he definitely does. He's got a good reputation in college and NBA. You know, whenever you got a guy that's played in college and knows, you know, the game so well, you're definitely feeling confident with that coach.
Whistle. Foul against Homestead on Luke Goody. That's his second personal foul. Joey Brown with two free throws coming up. He only has 2 points in this game so far. Only a sophomore, though. Missed that one. Second free throw coming up. As North Central still has not made 10 shots in this game. They're 9 of 32 from the field. Homestead 18 of 35. Second. Now that's good by Brown. With 3 points. North Central, they're 3 of 7 on free throws. This game, Homestead 3 of 4. Homestead 12 of 25 on 2-point field goals. North Central, they're only 5 of 20 on twos. And Homestead still 6 of 10 on threes. And North Central 4 of 12. 20-point lead for Homestead. Underneath. Lawyer makes the extra pass to a wide-open Luke Goody. Jackson lets it go out of bounds. North Central ball. This Homestead team, Chris, they're 3-0 on Saturdays. They're 8-0 in the non-conference. 3-0 at home, although it's been a while since they've been at home. Three of their first four games of the season were at home.
And six straight road games right there. And, you know, like I said earlier, you know, you'd be happy with getting four games won, but Homestead got all six, and, you know, that's just really impressive.
B.J. Williams, a three-pointer. He's now up to 11 points for North Central. Starting to get a little bit closer. I mean, Homestead's still in control. Lawyer. Simmons, the putback. And with that, Grant Simmons, a new season high with 16 points in this game. Passes his previous season high of 15 against Warsaw, which was back on December 4th, one of the first games of the season. 47-28, Homestead leading. Stolen away. Simmons, other end. Who's swatted. Nice play by Mike Elliott. Knock out of bounds, staying with Homestead, though.
You know, North Central, they got a big game coming up. They got to play Lawrence North, number one team. And win the state. Lawrence North got a really tough game today. They play Addicts at 6:30, so that's definitely a game that we want to watch out for.
Colpeen. A lot of missed shots right there for Homestead underneath the basket, but staying with Homestead. Because, yeah, North Central, they have Ben Davis Friday, then on Tuesday, January 12th, take on Lawrence North in the Marion County Tournament. Clark in for Walker. Lawyer with 12 points, Goody with 17, and Simmons with 16. This game for Homestead. Lawyer throws it up. Open for a foul, nothing is called. Three-pointer good, Mike Elliott. He's now to 11 points in the game. B.J. Williams also has 11 points to lead North Central. We're getting it closer, only 16 points now. Homestead, they got to keep their foot on the pedal in this one. Homestead, they don't play again until Friday, January 8th, which is a conference game against Southside at 7:30. Turnover on North Central. Sub in.
North Central trying to go too fast there.
Timeout called by Homestead, just a 30-second timeout. And look at some predictions for this game. Homestead was predicted by John Harrell to win 68-60. And Sagarin had Homestead as an 8.5-point favorite right now. And right now, Homestead is well above that, up by 16 points right now.
They doubled it. You know, they doubled that. But those North Central team, you know, like I said, they're not going to go down without a fight. They're going to try everything they can to battle back in this game and get back in it.
Homestead shooting 50% from three this game. North Central, they're knocking down quite a few threes as well, 43%, 6 of 14. Lawyer across half court. Over to Colpine. Goody. Got it. Luke Goody, a three-pointer. His first basket of this third quarter. Now with 20 points on the game, Luke Goody above his season average now of 18.8. Another three-pointer by Elliott. Missed it there, though. Simmons calls for it underneath. Should have been a three-man show in this game. Goody with 20, Simmons 16, and Lawyer 12. Lawyer drives in, is fouled, and the best free throw shooter in the country. We'll have two free throws coming up.
Now Homestead having a tough time, you know, finishing down low. They missed a couple, you know, layups down low, but able to get the ball back there, and a good way to draw a foul there for Fletcher Lawyer.
At that free throw again. Compared to his standards, I mean, Lawyer not having a good game. I mean, it's easy to say that when he put up 50 the last game and only has 13 points right now. I mean, average is basically 25 a game. He was honored before this game as he passed 1,000 career points, which was against Brownsburg on December 22nd as he gets that free throw as well, now with 14 points. Goody has 20, and Simmons with 16 for Homestead. So 50 of the 52 points scored by Homestead have come by Goody, Simmons, or Lawyer. Going the other way now for North Central. B.J. Williams, who has 11. Wide open three missed. That was Olsen. And zoom in on a fan. North Central fan. Caden Kapowicki and Quinn Harmonen.
Lady up there with the cowbell. She's definitely making some noise up there for North Central.
We're used to hearing that sound in the football season, someone ringing a bell like that. Another three by Williams. Boyd collects the rebound for North Central. It's Homestead, a 21-point lead. This third quarter winding down. Leaper, a clean block right there over 6'6", Joey Brown, Goody, crossover, spin move in the paint off glass, spins out, gets his putback, misses again. Rebound to Brown for North Central. Goody slow to get up. Lawyer, a nice block. May have been helped by the backboard. Caden Kopwicki, now Harmon. Two solid bench players. Leaper. It's a basket to go. Just the second basket of the game scored by someone not named Goody, Lawyer, or Simmons for Homestead.
It looked like an elbow right there. You know, it looks like he came flying in there with the elbows, but official calls foul on Leaper.
Quinton Boyd in the game, shooting these free throws for North Central. They really have a tough sectional, North Central. I mean, they have the best sectional, in my opinion, in the state by far. You have Lawrence North, Warren Central, Attucks, Cathedral, you know, a ton of good games.
A lot of entertaining games.
I mean, you just look at last year's sectional when Lawrence North, they somehow rallied to win that sectional. A lot of come-from-behind wins, a lot of last-second wins. As Homestead, they get a take on Lawrence North in just a short amount of time. That's on January 23rd, so just a few weeks from now.
That's definitely a game, you know, very excited to see.
Yeah, last year Lawrence North won, but Homestead was in it basically the entire game aside from the final few minutes of the fourth quarter. North Central season low in points scored is 49. They're at 33 right now. Has Simmons again, Grant Simmons. Now with 19 points. His career high is 21 points, which was against Lewis last season. As Boyd able to score. And you, Chris, look at someone like Grant Simmons. He averages 11.3 points per game. Another three for Simmons. This is that one. But Simmons actually a really good baseball player. Some of his baseball stats, as you look at that three by Simmons. He's a member of the Homestead baseball team, and of course the season was canceled last spring. So as a sophomore in 2018-19, 400 batting average and 10 at-bats, and a 1.69 ERA in 21.2 innings pitched. That's pretty solid. I mean, I'm not a baseball guy, but that's pretty good.
Well, he pitched six straight games for Homestead. You know, he had to pitch in all those games. He did really well. That 1.69 ERA, that's definitely a very good ERA for a pitcher.
And Boyd again, he's now up to seven. Yeah, Simmons going to Huntington University to play baseball. He's shooting 62% from two on the season. Grant Simmons heading into this game. Goody with 20, Simmons 19, and Lawyer 14. Simmons set to hold out the clock.
Go one shot here for Homestead.
No shot clock on Indiana allows them to do this. Simmons, who has 19, out to Goody, who has 20, out to Simmons for a career high, missed it. That'll be the end of the third quarter. Homestead leading 57-37 over North Central. They head into the fourth with a 20-point lead.
Here at Homestead High School Media, we're taking steps to stay safe during the COVID-19 pandemic. That includes limiting the number of workers in the TV studio and wearing masks when not on camera. We also socially distance our anchors each week at the news desk. In the studios, we limit the number of people allowed in at a time, and even our mics wear masks. Thank you for doing your part in helping fight COVID-19.
Start of the fourth quarter, it's 57-37. Homestead leading over North Central. It's been all Spartans from the start. A 17-0 run in the first half helped Homestead get out to a huge lead, as Homestead shooting 50% from three this game, 83% from the line, and from two, they're only shooting 39%, which is actually a bit odd. They're shooting better from three than two they are this game.
As Homestead team, you know, we talked about 10-0. They've done a great job so far, but we look for teams to give them tests. I think it's going to start with Blackhawk Christian coming up here in like a week and a half. That's definitely just a big game that everyone's going to be looking forward to. A couple Purdue commits playing in that game as well.
Yeah, so Homestead, after this game, they have Southside on Friday. Then after that Friday, January 12th, they take on Blackhawk, who's 2A number one, as Simmons again will have two free throws coming up. And if he's able to knock these both down, he will tie his career high. As Olsen picks up his first and the team's second. Homestead only three team fouls this half. Simmons, first free throw. Got it. Now with 20 points, Grant Simmons, he's having a really good game, Chris. One away from his career high.
Yeah, he's definitely, you know, done a good job so far. Able to create opportunities, getting open, you know, outside the perimeter and hitting those three balls, you know, left and right.
And he missed that. I mean, it's quiet in here, but not that quiet. I don't know if you heard me say that. Probably not. As Walker is fouled, Simmons just needs one more field goal, and he will have a new career high.
That'd definitely be a really good game for Simmons, able to get his career high. Definitely a confident booster for Simmons.
Leland Walker, 6'1" junior. He has offers from Providence, FIU, Little Rock, Middle Tennessee, Ball State, Winthrop, Xavier, and IUPUI. According to verbal commits, he averaged 20.2 points per game last season as a sophomore. At the line, 7:09 to go in the fourth. Get that one. Walker, that was 7 points in the game. Still a 19-point game. There's some time for North Central. They can shut Homestead down and start making some baskets.
Would be a tough comeback to make here, down by 19 points. Long way to go for North Central, but a couple stops and a couple baskets, they're right back in it.
Grant Simmons could knock down the three-pointer. Other end for Walker, North Central. Wants to push it. It's trapped. Two misses by North Central underneath the basket. Goody. Fade away, off glass, up and in. Luke Goody, 22 points. The future Illinois basketball player. Oh. 60-39 lead for Homestead right now over North Central. Thanks for joining us. It's been an exciting game if you're a Homestead fan, but if you're a North Central fan, it's been tough. But this only helps their strength of schedule for North Central. They're currently ranked as the fourth toughest schedule in the state. Goody missed the three. North Central, they played some of the best teams in the state. Lawyer underneath scores. Now with 16 points.
I mean, their conference is just loaded with talent. You got Warren Central, you got Carmel, you got Lawrence North. I mean, when you're playing a schedule like that, it definitely toughens you up and gets you prepared for the postseason.
Three-pointer by Leland Walker, who's been quiet in this game. Now just reached 10 points. Simmons. Put back, good, and Grant Simmons now 22 points, a new career high for him, passing his 21-point score against Bishop Lewis last season. Foul on Walker, picks up the offensive foul. Kyron Kopwick in for Homestead. Jackson and Brown in for North Central.
Harmon takes another charge there. He leads the team in charges drawn. There's four.
Yeah, fourth one of the season. Perfect pass. Goody underneath. That's a circus shot. Goody just kind of threw that one up. Great assist by Harmon right there. Two-pointer missed by Walker. Lawyer takes a tumble. Brown picks up his second. Goody with 24 points in this game. Grant Simmons 22, which is his career high. And Lawyer 16 points.
The Homestead, you know, including this year, they've always done a good job, you know, in conference. You know, before, it was last year, you finished fourth, you know, not the greatest, but then you got tied for first, second, third, and then first. You know, Homestead has found, you know, a lot of success, you know, playing within their conference.
Get Goody for a travel. He can't believe it. 66-42, Homestead leading. Goody leading the team and scoring with 24 points. Knocked out of bounds by North Central. Jackson couldn't hold on to it underneath. And Harmon again to inbound. We saw him have a great pass earlier. There he finds Kyron Kopwicki, a transfer from Carmel, only a sophomore. Simmons again in the corner. Automatic from Grant Simmons this game. 25 points and counting, and continues to add to his already career high. Three ball. And Simmons, nice to see him help Clark up. That was a tough foul, but three free throws coming for Clark. He averaged 6.8 points per game last season as a junior for North Central. That's the third foul on Grant Simmons. The 15th foul on Homestead.
Simmons up to 25 points already in this game. You know, it's beats his career high, like you said. You know, 25 points, so this Homestead team. You know, it's not just Lawyer, it's not just Goody. Simmons definitely adding to it tonight.
Free throw is good. Harmon checks out. .427 to go in the fourth. Second free throw also good. Homestead still shooting 47% from three this game. And only 44% from two. But North Central, they've only hit 7 twos this game on 26% shooting from two. They're 30% overall. Homestead's 45% overall in the game. North Central 9 of 14 from the line. Homestead 6 of 8 from the line.
You know, Homestead, you know, tonight they've done a great job on, you know, both sides of the ball. Defense has stepped up from North Central, you know, only 44 points. This Homestead team doing a great job on defense, and offense has been electric.
Simmons again. Yes, Grant Simmons, 28 points. What a game he's having for Homestead. Yeah, Fletcher Lawyer, who puts up 50 against Mayerhan. And he's having a bit of a quiet game. I mean, only 16 points, but then you have someone like Grant Simmons who's putting up 28, and Goody also has 24. And this Homestead team really has three really good players that can really go off in any game.
Yeah, think about in the postseason, when you have three guys that are above 15 points, you know, you always are going to have a good shot at winning that game.
Homestead, just about their season average points scored right now. They average about 75.7 on the season, 72 right now. They're 16th in the state in scoring average, 8th in 4A, and 2nd in the SAC as a dunk right there by Jackson. One more Homestead foul, and North Central shoots 1-1, although this point probably already over. Simmons underneath again. What a move! Oh, just rolled out.
Good move there by Simmons. You know, tough shot to take, and almost made it there.
Olsen with a swish. A 6'1" junior. It's a 20-point game. Lawyer to inbound.
Lady ringing the cowbells. North Central coming back in this one.
Simmons again. It's fouled on the way up. The fifth team foul of North Central.
You know, Grant's got a shot to get here to 30.
His previous career high was 21 points, which was last season against Bishop Lewers. Man, it got really quiet in here when he was about to shoot those. 29 points now for Simmons.
Going for 30 here.
Nice. Grant Simmons, 30 points. The player of the game for Homestead. The best game of his career. 30 points for number 32 in white. Three ball, no good by North Central. Brown able to put it back up and in. Goody goes up with it. He's able to draw a foul.
As Homestead team, they got a lot of postseason potential. You know, a lot of people picking them to get down to state. And you got Grant Simmons at 30, Goody at 24, and Lawyer at 16. And when you can have three guys, you know, shooting that well, you know what, you know, you're playing tough teams left and right, so definitely going to need these three guys firing on all cylinders throughout the postseason. And, you know, if they do that, you know, this Homestead team definitely can be dangerous down the stretch.
Look at Goody's stats right there. 53% from the field this game, 24 points. Now 25 points. So 71 of the team's 75 points have come by three players, Goody, Lawyer, and Simmons. Goody with 26 points now. Three-pointer again, and that is good by Davis Olson. Nice to see North Central still putting up some shots. Not giving up without a fight. Goody had 17 in the first half, now 9. In this half. Lawyer with 16 points. It's away. Kyron Kapuiki out of bounds going to North Central. And when you look at the rebounding department, Chris, Homestead doubling North Central, 38-19 in rebounds this game. That's a big reason why they're up. How big they are right now.
Well, anytime you can out-rebound someone, especially by that much, definitely putting yourself in a good position to win.
Lawyer goes up with a lay-in, now with 18 points. It's funny to say Lawyer's having a bad game, even though he has 18 points. Another three-pointer is good. Olson again. As the Spartans set to empty their starting JV lineup. Four of them onto the court. Ooh, what a pass by Goody, no look. Simmons with 30 points and counting. Goody with 26 points, and Lawyer with 18 points. I like to see Coach Johnson keeping out his starters this late into the game, or at least the main rotation players. Goody, what a pass underneath to Simmons. 32 points for number 32. Best game of his career. 11 points above his career high. 20-point lead for Homestead. Bank shot good by Boyd. Goody. I mean, these JV players might not even check in. All right, with that, they are. Saying if Homestead is just going to dribble out the clock, might not even get a chance. As a kudo, swing. Schiltz and Markham, and as well as Kyron Kapwicki still out there. You have some really good football players out there. Max Schiltz, a great linebacker for the football team. Grady Swing could be the starting quarterback next year. Three-pointer again, Davis Olson. Having four three-pointers as you have 10 seconds to go in this game. That's going to hurt the Sagarin. As North Central adds more points. So the final, Homestead wins 80-65, led by Grant Simmons, 32 points. for number 32, Goody with 26 and Lawyer with 18 points.
Well, this Homestead team, they came out shooting the ball really well, and you know, they didn't let up down the stretch there. Just kept going, and you know, they came through in a big statement win today.
Yeah, Homestead, a big win over North Central. They're 11-0 on the season now. Big win for the Spartans, and now let's send it down to sideline reporter Jenna Lane, who's with Luke Goody.
Hi, so statement win that you guys dominated from the start. How are you guys able to do that today?
We had a good game plan going in that we know they got a great player and some great coaches over there. We knew that we needed to stop number two. He was kind of their main guy and the main guy that scores. So I feel like we came out and we did that. Credit to Caleb Colpin and the rest of the team, the guys that came in and Caden that guarded him. They did a great job with him, and we were just able to get easy shots and play together as a team.
And then today we saw Grant Simmons step up with a career high. How good is this team when you get that kind of scoring from Grant?
I mean, this team is unstoppable, really, if you think about it. When you got two Big Ten guys on the team, two D1 guys, then you got guys that know their role and can hit shots. I mean, Grant Simmons had one of the best shooting days and scoring days that he's ever had. So for him to come out and do that, it's really a testament to our team and just shows that any guy can step up on any given day.
And 11-0 on the season now, how happy are you with the team's play up to this point?
I'm very satisfied right now, but there's always room for improvement. Our end goal is not to be 11-0 or whatever and 0, it's to win the state championship. So however we get there and however we need to improve is what we're going to come in and do every single day and try and get better.
And then you have a week off until you resume SAC play next week. So what do you guys need to work on between now and then?
We just need to come in and work hard every single day in practice, continue to do what we've been doing. Our practices have been great. Everybody's coming in with a determination and focus on our goals and what we need to do. So just to continue that and keep working hard every single day.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Matt, back to you.
Thanks, Jenna. That was Luke Goody. He had a great game. Good game for Goody. 26 points, but Grant Simmons, 32 points. We're going to take a quick break. Be right back with a post-game show after this.
What limits you? Too small, too old, insecure, broken. You have no limits. Rethink your limits.
This is the OPS post-game report.
Back with the post-game show, Chris Homestead wins 80-65. I mean, the score looks, you know, somewhat close, but Homestead really dominated from tip-off. And now looking at some of the stats, Homestead 80-65 win. They shoot 47% from the field. North Central only 39%. And North Central, they actually hit 11 threes. A lot of them coming late when the game was pretty much already decided. But Homestead, they shoot 50% from three. The rebounding still, Chris, big thing is both teams turn it over 9 times.
Well, you know, like you said, this team, you know, they came out flying, and then they didn't stop. You know, they hit their shots in the first half, and they came out in the second half and kept it going. You know, out-rebounding a team 38-19. I think any time you can out-rebound a team by double the rebounds, you know, you put yourself in a really good position to win the game.
Yeah, Homestead, an 80-65 win over North Central, now 11-0 on the season. So they don't play again until Friday against Southside here at home. And the Spartans had really three solid players that stepped up. But the main two, Grant Simmons, 32 points, a career high on 63% shooting. And Luke Goody, 26 points. A very good game from him on 53% shooting.
Anytime you can get three guys going at once, you know, three guys with, you know, more than 15 points, like, you know, like I said, you put yourself in the position to win the game and beat any team when you're, you know, scoring on high cylinders from, you know, not just one person. You add in two other guys that are, you know, playing a really good game. So, you know, this Homestead team, you know, now they're 11-0, and they don't seem like they're going to stop anytime soon.
Warrior, 18 points, and any final thoughts from you, Chris, today in this game?
You know, this Homestead team, 11-0. You know, got to keep it going. You got Southside, and then you got Blackhawk Christian. That's the game that everybody's going to get up for. You got Caleb First and Luke Goody going at it. So that's going to be a fun game. But 11-0, and no, can't wait to keep it going.
Thanks for watching today, and join us next Friday as Southside comes to Spartan Arena in a girls-boys SAC doubleheader. Tip-off for the girls' game is at 6 o'clock with the boys' game to follow. Thanks for listening. Signing off from Homestead High School.